mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Out!
You spirit husband, try! I command you now, out of her! Whatever that has been deposited into your body, come, manifest yourself and come out of her.
Out!
Everyone here, as the angels of God is setting many free now, your freedom is taking place right now. In the name of Jesus Christ.
More grace, everybody. My name is Benedicta Ugu. I'm here to testify the goodness of God in my life. Over 3 years, I've been having the problem of how to conceive. After I had my 2 kids, even before I had those 2 kids, it was battle. So after everything, I began to express many things in my dream, where I would see a man coming to make love with me in a dream. I'll be eating with unknowing people. I'll be doing things with people I don't know. So sometimes it will appear to be my husband spiritually. So each time I sleep at night, sometimes if I stretch my leg, I'll see a snake rise on my leg. I'll be screaming. I'll call my husband to come and feel it. When he wants to hold my leg, the snake will disappear. So I'll be going through this mess for years. Sometimes I will see myself, I will urinate in my matrimonial bed. My husband will be saying, ah, what kind of things is this one? He said, I don't know that this thing, I don't know where it comes from. I began to call my parents. So my dad is late. I call my mother, I say, ah, what have you people done to my life? Oh, see what is happening to my life? Oh, I can't even sleep. People should help me. Oh, tell me what you have done to my life when I was small. So my mom say, ah, when they get back to me, they did not take me to anywhere. Oh. And I said, and I remember one certain time. That time I was still in Lagos with my brothers. So the one that seen on me immediately, he was not sick. So they now took him to one native doctor in my village. So I now came down from Lagos to know how he was faring. So when I got there, the native doctor now saw me. He said that I'm possessed, that his enemy, not me, had Ogbanje. That my mother should go and buy things, that she would take me to the river to do some sacrifice. So my mother was ignorant. Me, I was ignorant. I don't know. So then I went and bought some things and took me to the river. But on that way, when we are going to the river, my mother was at the front. I was in the middle. A tall man holding a glass was at the back following me. They said, I will go to the river. So when we now go to the river, and I said that they should leave me, that I don't belong to them, and I throw those things. They said I should not look back. When we now go back to the native doctor, he now gave me some mark. So I now told my mother, are you sure is this not what is disturbing me? That I can't sleep, oh, I can't even sleep at night. I'll be praying, I'll be fasting, I'll be going from church to churches. So there was one church I was going that time. The woman told me many deliverance. He did many deliverance to me. I used salt to bath for complete 3 years. If I don't use salt, all the movement in my body, I can't even stay. Every night I don't even sleep. People will be sleeping, me or me, I will be praying. Because it's only that prayer and I'm singing, that when I'm singing, God will be destroying those things, nullifying those things in my body. Without prayer, I don't think I will survive till today. So I keep on believing God, praying, going to church. I dedicated myself that it's only Wednesdays and Friday I will be going to church, that woman's church. So I keep on going for 3 years. The woman keep on doing deliverance for me. Last year, I did deliverance more than 6 times. It was no way. I was still having what I was still seeing in my life. So last year, December, we were about to travel. Because of this matter, I did not travel for 2 years. I was ashamed to travel to my village. So one woman now called me, said, you know, one child that would take me to that. That child that she was having a problem for her 7 years, that she came here and she received her deliverance. I said, okay, that she just take me to this place for me to know here. That day was on Saturday. She now brought me here. When she brought me here, everywhere was closed. And I just peeped through the window. I said, God, this is my last bus stop. As I said that word, I felt cold in my body. I said, okay, when I left, that woman, I say amen. So I now left. So I was afraid to tell my husband that I want to wait for the following week for the deliverance. Because that week we are planning to travel. So I was afraid to tell because he might not allow me to wait for that week. So I said, okay, no problem, that I will travel. That if I come back, I will come for my deliverance. So we now traveled to our village. So when we traveled, when we got home, my husband's mother, they said, I do pray this day, so that I can't even sleep at night. They, where they marry me, I don't used to pray like this. I say, if I don't pray for a second, I will die. Because what I'm seeing, things in my body, moving in my body. If I don't pray, I don't sing to God to nullify those things, I can't be. They say this kind of thing, they have not seen it. Then I say I should be going for one, they describe one place that I should be going to take medicine and all those things. I say, So then I took me there, the woman, something like that. So then I took me for one native woman like that. They said, the woman say he be Christian, no. Say they go church. Say he medicine. Say after he prepare, say he go pray before they go drink medicine. And I say I should go and bring a native fowl and a four yam. And may not mention, and I say, a Christian something say, fowl, what does fowl have to do? And four yam. Since he say, nah, Christian. My husband mother say I should just do with that. He had a sister that has maybe about 5 years is not born. That it was that woman that helped her that before she not deliver. So I said, okay. Then the woman ran the kitchen the price. The woman I say it was 20,000 I'm going to bring. So I said, I don't have that 20,000 no. We now negotiate up to 15,000. So she now say I should give her money for all those fowl and everything that if I could not pay all, that if we return back to Eto, maybe that will send her down the money. That she's going to prepare the medicine. So when the woman prepared the medicine and everything, he said that this medicine is going to give me the rules and regulation that follow it. That anytime I want to drink the medicine, I should not wear my slippers and drink it. Then as I'm carrying the medicine home because I came with the bag, he said, as I'm holding this medicine like this, if I see somebody I know and I drop that medicine and shake the person, he said, the glory of that medicine has gone to meet that person, which means the medicine will not work again. I said, how will I going to do it? If I see somebody I know, which means I will not greet the person. He said, I can greet the person with the mouth. Or I will drop the medicine on the ground. Let the medicine be on its own. Me, I will be on my own. Before I will not greet the person. I said, okay, this one I will allow. I said, and I bought a bike from my village to my neighbor. To my, because it was a neighboring village to my own. So I now, luckily to me, people I was just seeing, there were not people that were closer to me. So God helped me and I got home. So when I got home now, I now dragged the medicine. My case was very worse. It was very worse. I said, now wow, I keep on praying. I said, it's only prayer that can help me. All these things you wish I should go and do, it can't help me. Because for years, it's prayer that has been sustaining me. It's only when I sing, and if I sing very well and pray very well, I will see the anointing of God falling on me. When I found those things, my body will not be relieved a bit. I was taking the medicine. In the night, I don't even sleep. The spiritual man will come to mess me up. Will come to do all sorts of things. I will not even sleep. See, they say I pray too much, that I should lower my voice. So anytime I get up now, I will be praying in my mind. I don't always make them to hear that I'm still praying. But in my mind, I know that I'm not sleeping, that I'm praying. So when I return back to Edo, my mind, all those I know that my mind was here. So I came that day. That day, I came on the 25th of January. So that day, the following day was on Tuesday. So I never know they have already changed it to Tuesday. I was thinking that it was on Wednesday. So I came on Tuesday. So the sister told me that I should come next week. I was asking God, will I survive till next week? Because my case was very worse. I can't even sleep again. All my body movement, on my head, as if someone wants to run mad. I was keep on praying to God. And I collected one anointing. Home. I started using that anointing oil. I was still sick. I started feeling very okay. So I now came for that deliverance, for that prayer land. After the man of God prayed for me on that day, I immediately touched my head. The devil in me vibrated. After everything now, I now went home. So the following day, after Thursday, and was the day a woman that was looking for the fruit of womb normally come for prayer. So I came on that day, it was on Friday. When the prayer was going on, after every day, they asked us to drink the blood of Jesus 21 times. After we used our hand to drink the blood of Jesus 21, my body was now weak. I was now as if I was now turning. People were now, I said, leave me. Nobody should not leave me. Everybody, nobody should hold me, that they should leave me. So that day, and after everything, and I fell down. So when I got home, I went to my anointing straight. I brought out my anointing. I said, God, whatever that is not planted in my life, I have three things to measure. Either I pass it out, or it came out from sweat, or I vomit it out. After I minted my anointing, and I drank it. After I drank the anointing, next 10 minutes, I cannot stand up. I cannot sit down. My body was weak. Me, I wanted to prepare something for my children to eat. I told them I cannot do anything. My body was weak. I can't even stand. I can't do anything. Ha, small time. Toilet now, as if I wanted to go and defecate. So I now went to the toilet. I said, let me use my baby pole. So when I used my baby pole, I saw blood coming out from my body and some other things I cannot explain. I passed out that blood for 2 good days. When my husband came back, I showed him to see. So after everything, that mode passed me. I did not see anything. The second mode passed me. I went to do test now and said I am pregnant.
There is joy, joy, joy in the presence of the Lord, singing hallelujah, amen. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout, this month is my month.
This month is my month.
Somebody shout, this month is my month.
This month is my month.
I have told you, you yourself, either you like it or believe it or not, this month, God must attend to you.
Yeah.
Sit down. Somebody shout, thank you, Jesus. When you thank God for another person, God will also make people to thank God for you. We bless the name of the Lord for what God has done for our sister. You saw how the story came. When she were giving birth, the parents never took her to any idol. But she went to greet her person. She's in Lagos. The native daughter said, you are possessed. You need deliverance. And they now follow. Okay, let's go and do it. They went to the river to do it. He said one thing. There is one that carried one long mirror. Follow them at the back. So, they do the deliverance, do everything, okay. Spirit husband came in. Problem began. Listen, it is not everything you hear from people you believe. So, you saw all the experience this sister had. She became a prayer warrior. But the more she prayed as well, the tail were still there. in every situation, you need a helper. Yes. You were having different signs in the dream. Nightmare, spirit husband, nonsense. They seem to be increasing every day. She will sleep in the night. Snake will tie her leg. She will call her husband. The husband wants to come and touch her leg, the snake will disappear. The husband will see nothing. In that case, it will be difficult for the husband to believe. The husband will now begin to see her disturbing him. The forces troubled her that she will sleep in the night. She will urinate on her matrimonial bed. She will sleep. She wake up. She see urine on the bed. She was going to a fellowship or a church. They were doing deliverance for her every time. She said she used salt to bath for how many years? 3 years. Salt. Pack salt on water for 3 years. The village, they took her to a place. They will do mercy for you. They charge the money again. They went to do it again. They say, if you are taking this mercy home, don't greet somebody on the road as you hold this mercy. You see, sometimes when one is having problems, challenges, temptation, people who are not supposed to control you will begin to control you. She took the mercy, the thing became worse as well. But to God be glory. Somebody brought her to the church here. Said the person brought her on Saturday. Show her the church. When she stretched her neck from the window, looked the church. He said, Lord, this is my last bus stop. And she made that statement. She said she felt a cool, the presence of God over her. That is one sign you experience whenever you come here. And she registered for prayer line. As she came to the prayer line, I registered the prayer line, and she was prayed for. After the prayer line, the woman went ahead and got the victory oil. When she got home, she prayed. Madam, what was your prayer? As you hold the victory oil in your hand, what was your prayers?
I said three things has to happen. I said, God, whatever I did not plant in my body, as I take this victory oil, I want it to come out through sweating. Or I vomit it out, or I pass it through urine, or through defecation.
You saw it? Whenever you are praying, know what you are talking about. Don't just be talking. Be specific. Know what you are talking about. She made a decree. That is the prayer called decree prayers. And as she took the victory oil, 10 minutes time, her body was not normal anymore. She planned to prepare food for her children. When she saw her body was not normal, she couldn't help herself. She sat down. Now, the washing and setting was taking place. The Holy Ghost was doing the washing and setting. And when it was time, she felt going to the toilet. She went to the toilet. All she passed out from the toilet were blood. Those were the fibroids that the spirit husband deposited to block her womb. It was the fibroid that turned to blood that began to melt out, that she were passing out. How many days you say you passed the blood out?
2 days.
2 days you were passing blood out.
Yes.
Thank you. And you show it to your husband.
Yes.
After passing out the whole thing, the washing and setting took place. Then at the end, what she had been believing God for? For long happened, and God gave her a new baby to the glory of his holy name. May we give a clap of it to Jesus Christ. Yes, this is what God can do. This is a great testimony. We thank God for what God has done for you. So, sister, since you came to the prayer line, do you sleep normal now?
Yes, I sleep well.
What of those dreams you have been dreaming?
I don't see them anymore. I don't see them anymore.
With this God have done for you, What advice do you have to give us who are hearing your testimony today?
My advice is this, my brothers and sisters. Be strong in your prayer and have faith. Because if you are not strong in your prayer, there are some trials that will come in your life and they will take you unawares. Just be strong in your prayer and believe God. One day, God will help you out.